When you don't get a lot of acting work, you have to make the magic happen. And I've always had a real love of stop motion animation, it's called. So today I'm gonna work on making a stop motion animation reel. So it's not gonna be acting per se, it's gonna be acting through plastic and a software program that I don't know how to use yet, but I'm gonna read the manual online extensively. So what I'll do with these little fellas is make some movements, make their parts move, and touch them frame by frame, and then submit those projects to stop motion animation companies or people. I'm not sure how it's organized.
That looks great. This is pretty easy, pretty straightforward.
I don't think you're meant to use copyrighted objects, but surely this isn't a cohesive. This doesn't look like any. This just is a machine. This is a small mod. It's McDonald's based, and he doesn't even have a face. So I don't think anyone's gonna sue. Sometimes you have to venture into the unknown, and you have to use new tools and techniques, and things you don't understand very well. You know, one of the things I think I'm going to do with stop motion is use it to really show my face and to use it in a new way, to show the details of the movements of this part of my body, which is right on the head, the front part of my head. I think stop motion is going to reveal the smaller movements, the expressions. It's going to sort of hold the expression in a way that really forces it on the audience's own face. It's a job. It's going to be a job. It's going to be my new career for a little bit, just while the acting is warming up in New York. It's a new stop motion based career move temporarily in my own time. Anything I can add to my resume at this point is just going to help the world to see various abilities that I have using small plastic people in this particular instance.
Oh, God.
His face says everything. Even though he only has one expression, you're able to read a lot into that one expression.